So you just installed iOS 14, but you don't know where to start? Well, here are some tips to help you get started. Let's start off by cleaning up that home screen of yours. Reduce the clutter. iOS 14 offers users to remove entire app pages from their home screens and store everything in the new app library. To do this, simply long press on your home screen to enter into what Apple calls jiggly mode, and then tap the page indicator icon at the bottom. From here, you can uncheck entire pages at one time in order to help reduce clutter. You can also long press on an app and tap remove from home screen to avoid deleting the app entirely, but instead move it to your app library. To access your app library, just swipe from right to left. Now that you've removed all of those unnecessary apps from your home screen, it's time to fill that space with useful information that can be found inside of some of the new iOS 14 widgets. Head back into jiggly mode by long pressing the home screen, and then tap the plus icon in the top left corner. You can now scroll through a list of your system and first-party widgets available now, with more to come from third-party developers very soon. There are multiple sizes of widgets to choose from, and you can even create stacks of widgets by dragging and dropping them on top of one another, and then swiping up or down to actively switch to see which widget is present at each time. If there's a person or group that you chat with frequently and you want those conversations in a more easily accessible location, then you should take advantage of iOS 14's new pinned conversation feature. You can do this by swiping from left to right on the individual or group's name and then tapping the pin icon. Pinned messages stay right at the top for quick and easy access. If you're in an overly active group chat, there are a few things that you can do to make sure some of your messages don't go unnoticed. You can long press on a message inside of a chat to find the new inline reply feature, and you can also specifically mention or tag a person's name, which sends a notification to that person, letting them know that their name has been mentioned in the conversation. To do this, simply type the person's name and then tap on it to mention them. You can now send audio messages using Siri to friends and family by just asking Siri to send your friend an audio message. It's very quick and convenient. Safari received a few helpful features, like a new translate button that lives inside of the navigation bar and appears when you would need it. Just tap the text icon in the navigation bar and then select translate to English or whatever your language is set to. There's also another new feature that you can find by tapping that text icon in Safari. All the way at the bottom is a new privacy report option, letting you know how websites are tracking you and giving you more information about how each website treats your privacy. And finally, if you own AirPods or AirPods Pro, iOS 14 and AirPods firmware update now brings us new features like spatial audio for you AirPods Pro owner out there that gives users a surround sound element using dynamic head tracking to put sounds happening on screen in the right place in your ears, even if you turn your head or move your device. Both sets of AirPods will also receive the new automatic switching feature, which seamlessly moves audio between devices without having to manually select your AirPods in settings. And you'll also get a blessed new notification letting you know your AirPods are about to run out of battery, giving you the ability to charge before they run out completely. These are just a few of the many new features, tips, and tricks that are out there for iOS 14, and if you want more in-depth walkthroughs of each feature out there, or some tips and tricks, be sure to check out the channel for all of our previous iOS 14 coverage. This has been Dan with MacRumors, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you around in the next video.